धन्यवाद धन्यवाद मिस राजी श्री तपन कुमार सेन श्री तपन कुमार सेन
एट द आउटसेट डेप्यूटी चेयरमैन सर आई बेग इंडल्जेंस इन द मैटर ऑफ टाइम टू प्रेजेंट माय व्यूज ऑन दिस बिल आई स्टैंड टू अपोज दिस बिल इन टोटलिटी एंड आई डिमांड दैट हाउस मस्ट स्क्रैप दिस दिस इज अ बिल एट एवरी स्टेज इट विल हिट द बेसिक इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द नेशन. Honorable Finance Minister, while presenting the bill, I told that this bill aims at bigger insurance penetration, bigger coverage of the health insurance, etc., to cover all the people. I have a different definition of the aims and objectives of the bill. This bill basically aims at hike the FDI cap, hike, privatize the, pave the way for gradual privatization of the public sector insurance company. These are the two basic twin objectives with which the bill was formulated, and there are many other provisions also. And these are not in the interest of the nation. Let us first take the issue of FDI cap. Raising the FDI cap, you are trying to have bigger foreign partner in the Indian insurance companies. The Indian insurance company, who are the player who are going to come here? The all insurance giants in the USA and Europe, most of them are already in partnership with a private insurance company, around 40-odd private insurance companies operating in the Indian soil. And what is their contribution in expanding the coverage, insurance coverage? Since the time they were allowed to enter into the Indian insurance market, as very effectively Ram Gopal ji has pointed out, the more the FDI is increasing, the more the dominance of the foreign companies in the operation of even the private insurance companies are growing, the insurance penetration is going down. Because all these private companies with foreign partnership are basically operating in the cities and the peripheral areas on the creamy layer. They don't go in the cities, in the villages, to cover poor people out of their insurance cover. This is real fact. And wherever they will go, two and three cases are there. They have gone for the crop insurance, weather insurance, and every other cases. These are all matter of record with the Finance Ministry also. They have made a scam. And in some cases, the scam could not be suppressed because we have raised those issues, gave letters after letter, and ultimately government has to take action in getting back the money that was given to them from the government kitty as a part of the premium for the BPL households in Rajasthan weather insurance scheme. They have to pay back the money. Wherever they have touched in the public domain of poor people's insurance, they made a scam. And that's why, that explains, the more your FDI is increasing, your FDI penetration is going down. Earlier it was 5%, at this moment it is 3.1%, and 49%, definitely it will come below 1% if the public sector insurance company take a countervailing expansionary step to cover it up. And this is the story of insurance penetration. And because of their role, the private sector insurance, public sector insurance company, today 3%, when Indian insurance penetration is 3.1%, it favorably converts when it compares with the insurance penetration of USA, which is also 3.1%. With the 100% FDI coverage, as my friend Chandan Mitra told, with the 100% FDI coverage, the USA's insurance penetration is 3.1%. And India's insurance penetration is 3.17%. Why, sir? Why this exercise? Insurance is a business for which capital does not come out of abroad. Insurance is a business on which the business main capital is the premium or savings, premium-related savings contributed by the consumers, by the clients.
2 minutes more. 2 minutes.
No, sir. Sorry. Sorry, we from the very beginning I protested about this unilateral exercise. This bill cannot have 2 hours. you have must allow me to pay, place all my points. Sorry. And this was agreed to also. This was agreed to in the morning also. You can't do it.
But you can't go on and on and on.
No, no, I can't go on. You must allow me to place my point.
How many more minutes?
Otherwise, I'll sit down here itself.
How many more minutes?
I must complete my points. You must allow.
Okay, you have 4 minutes. I'll give you double that time, nothing more than that.
No,
carry
sir,
on.
You have,
please carry
I
on.
Must complete my
carry
presentation.
Carry on.
You're already 2 minutes.
I cannot do so, what,
sir,
what
my
I,
second
which is
point
not
is
possible.
That who are the people? They are all bankrupt in their countries. All bankrupt in their countries. Surviving out of the government exchequer, bailout given by the government. And this 49% hike is an additional bailout being given by the poor government of India's exchequer. It's an additional bailout to those bankrupt companies. So they will come here, collect the Indian people's savings out of insurance and have their own business. You are giving them an additional bailout at the cost of Indian, Indian poor people, Indian consumers. This is not in national interest. And the serious, to facilitate that process, what you have done? The coverage, the security coverage. Earlier there is a provision that any asset outside India will not be taken into account to consider their net worth. There was a provision in the existing law. Even that provision was also deleted. Subservience to outside interest can go to what extent that such an anti-national provision can be made in the bill? That a foreign company's net worth will be calculated on the basis of a property outside. If the company fails, you can't attach that property outside.
Yes.
This time you deliberately deleted that provision, that restriction, and allowed the property outside also to be computed as a part of those. Sir, what benefit will you gain out of it? What benefit will you gain out of it? What benefit the country will get out of it? The second aspect of this bill is you are privatizing, open the door of privatization to General Insurance Corporation. You are allowing disinvestment there to collect resources. The GIC, please.
Allow.
Please, with all respect to chair, please allow me. With all respect.
You had 4 minutes. I am giving you double the time. I can't do more than that.
There is an understanding. Minister is here.
I am giving you double the time.
Number three, you are opening, you are allowing disinvestment of the shares of GIC. Kya sir, baith jayega? Toh bolo baith jata.
Nahi nahi.
Baith jata hai, kya hai? No problem. Where do you mean?
Thank you very much.
What is this going on?
Take 2 more minutes, but it can't be open-ended. It can't be open-ended.
You are going to disinvestment in GIC. Do they need money and what is the law? What is the logic? That in order to raise resources from the market, they have to go for selling their equity. There are n number of ways of raising resources from the market. Why equity dilution? Because you have to allow private sector participation in their director board to infringe on their right of smoothly running the company. You kindly check, Honorable Finance Minister, the reserve, the huge reserve GIC is having. And the credibility of GIC in the market, in the financial institution. Or in that matter, the credibility of the entire public sector companies in the country. Their debt equity ratio is less than 5, 0.5 or 0.7. Their credibility in the credit market, bank market is very big. They don't have any dearth of resources if they want to collect from the market. They need not dilute their equity or their ownership quality. You are doing it to open the door of privatization. That was the basic philosophy. And
thank
number
you,
three,
thank
for
you
efficiency.
Much. Thank you, sir.
For efficiency and...
You are speaking very well, but I can't help it. You
for
have
efficiency,
to be in...
you are sitting. You again told
okay,
to speak.
Okay.
Then you are speaking.
Okay. Take half a minute more.
Sir, the question of efficiency. Does anywhere compare our private insurance company with foreign partners? All this AIG, Fortis, all they are already operating in our country.
Thank you.
You compare the efficiency. 1% is the rejection rate of LIC. 1%. Whereas all private insurance company, the rejection rate is 20 to 33%. Their policy getting lapsed, the percentage is 47%. What does it mean policy is getting lapsed? Poor people with an aggressive marketing strategy by multi-layer marketing, which is called Ponzi. Most of the private insurance company, more than 60% of their business are Ponzi, are collected through Ponzi.
Thank
you. With an aggressive marketing, they become purchase share policy, and thereafter they could not continue.
Thank you very much.
These are the laps, and the whole money goes to the kitty of the company.
Thank you, Dilip Tirki.
So this is a kind of efficiency they are projecting, and
thank
for making it more efficient, you are inviting and you are
thank
privatizing
you very much.
The whole
thank you very
sector.
Much. Thank you.
Sir,
thank
this is not in the interest of the country. This is not in the interest of the financial economy. I urge the government to please reconsider this.
Thank you. Dilip
and
Tirki.
Please, by LIC chairman's statement, don't get confused. On 9th March, the employees of LIC and GIC, represented by all unions, right, left and center, even your union is also there, they have completely gone on 100% strike to protest against this.
Thank you.
You may pass the bill, but thereafter implementation, there will be resistance in the workplace level.
Thank you.
As a trade union
Dilip
activist,
Tirki.
I like to issue this warning to the government. Please don't go in that direction.
Thank you.
With this, I urge upon to scrap this bill, withdraw the bill, with this request.